Hey everyone, welcome to the 9th episode of the Bioterminal Classroom. So in this episode, I will teach you how to use the microphone and the buzzer on the Bioterminal. So now, let's get started. So now, let's look at what we are going to learn today in this episode. So I will mainly talk about the buzzer and the microphone on the Bioterminal in this video. So I will first talk about the buzzer and explain you what a buzzer is, then talk about different types of buzzers, and then move on to the passive buzzer on the Bioterminal. After that, I will show you how to configure the passive buzzer in different ways, and finally I will use the buzzer to play a melody. Then I will move on to the microphone and explain you a little bit about what a microphone is and show you the microphone on the Bioterminal. And finally, in there I will show you three demos of using the microphone. So now let's talk about buzzers. So what is a buzzer? So a buzzer is an electronic component which can generate sound. So when we normally use buzzers with an Arduino, we use piezo buzzers. So these piezo buzzers contain a piezoelectric vibration plate inside an enclosed case. So when you connect a piezo buzzer to an Arduino, and when you apply a voltage to the buzzer, the piezo element inside the case vibrates, and then after that a sound is emitted. So this is how a piezo buzzer works. So when talking about buzzers, there are two main different types of buzzers. They are active buzzers and passive buzzers. So an active buzzer has an internal oscillating source, and the buzzer will sound as soon as it is energized. And these active buzzers communicate with an Arduino using the digital interface, and they can be easily driven by a simple DC voltage input. So this is a Grove active buzzer, and we offer this in the Grove family. You can connect this Grove buzzer to an Arduino easily using the 4-pin Grove connector. So now let's talk about the passive buzzer. So the passive buzzer does not have an internal oscillating source like an active buzzer, and a passive buzzer has to be driven with a square wave with different frequency. So when you apply a simple DC voltage input to the passive buzzer won't work like an active buzzer. In order for the passive buzzer to work, you need to send these square waves to the passive buzzer. So just like the active buzzer, it communicates with an Arduino using digital interface, and you need a simple PWM input just like an analog input to control this buzzer. So this is the Grove passive buzzer, and we offer it in the Grove family. So in order to distinguish between the active buzzer and a passive buzzer, you can connect a battery to the buzzers, and if the buzzer sounds when you connect a battery, it means it is an active buzzer, and if the buzzer doesn't sound, that means it is a passive buzzer. So the Bioterminal has a passive buzzer included inside, and if you look here closely at the back of this enclosure, you can find a passive buzzer soldered onto the PCB board. So these are the specifications of the passive buzzer that we have used inside the Bioterminal. So mainly it has a sound output of 78 decibels at 10 centimeters, and it has a resonant frequency of 4000 Hz. So as I have explained to you before, all the pin definitions are defined at variant.h. So similarly, the pin definitions for the buzzer is also defined inside the variant.h. So if you go and find this file variant.h inside this directory, or you can search it inside the search bar, you can open it and you can search for buzzer. So as you can see here, the buzzer pin is defined as buzzer CTR or wire buzzer. So you can use either of these pin definitions to define the connected passive buzzer on the Bioterminal. Now let's move on to configuring the passive buzzer on the Bioterminal. So you can configure the passive buzzer in two different ways. So you can use the analog write function or the digital write function to control the passive buzzer. So at first, let's use the analog write function to control the buzzer. So I have explained to you before that you can use PWM signals to control the buzzer. So this buzzer is connected to a digital pin on the ATSAM D51 chip. So this digital pin is also PWM enabled. That means you can send PWM signals to control this pin. Now let's open Arduino and use this analog write to control the passive buzzer. So let's write a simple code here. So we don't need to define any libraries here because we will only use the digital interface on the Wio terminal. So first, inside the setup, let's define the pin. So pin mode Wio buzzer. So I have showed you on the variant.h file, the buzzer is defined like this. And let's set it as an output. After that, let's write our codes inside the loop. So let's write analog write. This is the pin Wio buzzer. And I will write an analog value, a random analog value. I will write it 150 and add a delay of 1 second, which is 1000 milliseconds. And I will add another analog write. Analog write. Set the pin Wio buzzer and set it as 0. So what this will do is, this will beep the buzzer with a 1 second interval. So now let's upload this code to the board. So now we will talk about how to use digital write function to control the passive buzzer. So when using the digital write function, we will generate a square wave and send it to the Wio terminal. So to generate a square wave, we will set the buzzer pin to high for a short time and set to low for another short time, and then high, low, high, low. So in this way, it will generate a square wave, and by that the buzzer will start to sound. So let's open Arduino again and let's start writing our codes. First, let's set the resonant frequency of the passive buzzer. So int frequency equals, so if you go back here, I have showed you before that the resonant frequency of the connected passive buzzer on the Wio terminal is 4000. So let's add 4000 here as the resonant frequency. Let's add a comment also, resonant frequency. After that, let's add the cycle. So int cycle. So int here means an integer data type. So the cycle set to 1 million, so 1 million milliseconds, which is 1 second, divided by the frequency. After that, let's write our codes inside the setup. So let's initialize the buzzer pin. So pin mode, let's define the buzzer Wio buzzer, and let's set it as an output. After that, let's start writing our codes inside the loop. So digital write, set the buzzer pin Wio buzzer, and let's set it to high for this amount of time. So delay microseconds. So that's the delay. And I will write it as cycle divided by 2. So what will happen here is, the buzzer will be set to high for this amount of time. So this cycle divided by 2 means half a cycle. So for half a cycle, the buzzer pin will be set to high, and digital write Wio buzzer, let's set it to low for the other half. So micro seconds cycle divided by 2. So here for the second half of the cycle, the buzzer pin will be set to low. So first half high, second half low. Then again, this is a loop, so again it will be high, low, high, low. So in this way, a signal with a square wave will be input to the buzzer. Now let's upload this code to the Wio terminal. So now it's time to have some fun with the buzzer. So what we will do is we will play a melody on the buzzer. So this is the wiki page for the buzzer used on the Vio terminal. So I will give a link to this URL in the video description down below so that you can also visit this page. So if you go down in this page, you can see there's a code to play melodies on the buzzer. So what we will do now is we will open Arduino and we will copy this code and paste it inside Arduino. So I will go through this code now. So at first, the buzzer pin is redefined as buzzer pin. So this is the buzzer pin definition inside the variant.h file, Vio buzzer, and this pin definition is redefined as buzzer pin, so that when this pin is defined, it's defined as buzzer pin inside this code. So buzzer pin, so here buzzer pin, all defined as buzzer pin. And then here the number of notes is set. So this is 15. So in this melody, there are 15 notes to be played. And these are the notes that are going to be used to play. So C, C, G, G, A, A, G, F, F, E, E, D, D, C. So these are the notes. So these notes actually are given a specific frequency in here. If you look here at the bottom, so each and every note is given a specific frequency. So with this frequency, that note is played. And for the beats, this is the time duration between each note. So between these notes, only there's only one beat. So C, C, G, G, A, A, G. So G has to drag for a couple of beats. So we have written two here. So which means for two beats, G will be played. And then this is the tempo. The tempo means the speed at which this melody will be played. And then in the setup, the pin mode is defined as a buzzer pin and as an output. And inside this loop, this is written to play the notes. So here you can see, as before, we are generating a square wave. So we are generating a high, and then after a short period, it will be set to low. So high, low, high, low, it will be generated a square wave. So in this way, this melody can be played. So let's upload this code to the board first. So here I will play another melody. I'll change this to 17 and I will change the notes to C, 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 E, A, 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 G, E, 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 B, 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 and I will keep a space here. And after that I want it 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, it should be 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And the last note, I will drag it 4 beats. And then I will change the tempo to 320. So now let's upload this code. So now let's go ahead and talk about microphones. So normally when you use a microphone with Arduino, we use Electret microphones. So these microphones are able to capture or respond to sound vibrations from across all angles. So when these microphones capture sound vibrations, they convert them into electrical pulses. And later these pulses are amplified over a speaker to achieve much louder sounds. So normally when you use these microphones with Arduino, we use the analog interface to communicate between the devices. So this is the Grove analog microphone. So you can see here the Grove analog microphone. So this microphone has a Grove port, so you can easily connect to your development boards using the Grove cables. So Vio terminal also has this type of Electret microphone, and you can find it under the enclosure here. So under the enclosure on top of the PCB board, an Electret microphone is soldered. So it's just near the buzzer. So microphone and buzzer are actually soldered next to each other. And here you can find the specifications of the microphone that we have used inside the bioterminal. So let's go back to our variant.h file to check the microphone pin definitions. So going back to this file, let's type mic. So here you can see mic input is defined as mic input or bio mic. So you can use any of these definitions inside your Arduino code to use the microphone. So first let's test our microphone. So we will use the serial monitor on the Arduino to check the microphone. So let's open Arduino. So we will write a simple code here. So to set up, we'll write the pin definitions, pin mode and wire mic. So as we have seen in variant.h file, the mic is defined as wire mic. Let's set it as an input. And let's do serial.begin because we are going to use the serial monitor here, the serial monitor on the wire terminal. So to start the serial communication, we need to write serial.begin. Let's set the baud rate as 115200. After that, inside the loop, so int val, I'll set the val to analog read wire mic. So what this will do is this will read the analog data from the microphone and save it into this val variable. So save it as an integer because we have set the data type as int. So let's write serial.println. So this is the print on the serial monitor. So let's print the val on the serial monitor. Let's set a delay of 200 milliseconds. Let's upload this code now. So now let's move on to an interactive demo using the mic. So in this demo, when the microphone detects a loud sound, the wire terminal LCD screen will display as too loud. Now let's open the Arduino code that we used before. So here we don't need the serial communication, so we'll delete it and we'll delete this as well. So at first, let's include the TFT ESPi library, so TFT ESPi.h, and after that let's initialize that library, so ESPi TFT, and then let's create a buffer TFT ESPrite SPR. So I have explained to you in my previous video that when you do this, the LCD screen will be much faster, and TFT. After that, inside the setup, we have already set the wire mic as input. And let's begin the TFT LCD by writing tft.begin. And let's set the rotation. Set rotation as 3. Let's create the sprite, spr.create sprite. TFT height, the wire terminal height, and TFT width, which is wire terminal width. After that, let's write our codes inside the loop. So let's do spr.fillSprite. So we will fill the screen with black color. So TFT black. And then let's set the text size. Set text size as 5. And then let's set a text color. Set text color, set it as red. Now let's write an if loop. So if analog read, so analog read via mic, so this is the analog input, so all the analog values will be read from this command. Analog read is greater than 800, TFT.drawString
draw it as too loud. So draw it at 30x location and 100y location. And let's add a delay of 2 seconds, which is 2000 milliseconds. So here, when the analog read value is more than 800, this text will be displayed on the VIO terminal LCD screen. So normally, more than 800 value will be a loud sound. So let's push this to the LCD screen. SPR.push sprite 00. And let's add a delay of 50 milliseconds. Now let's upload this code to the board. Now let's move on to the final demo of this video. So what we will do here is we will try to display the analog readings from the microphone on the VIO terminal LCD screen as a line graph. So I've explained to you before in my previous videos how to draw line graphs on the VIO terminal LCD screen. So if you go to the VIO terminal classroom YouTube playlist, you can see VIO terminal classroom 5 explains how to draw line charts. So you can follow this video to know more about line charts. And also, if you go to this wiki, the line charts wiki for the VIO terminal, you can learn how to draw line charts on the VIO terminal. So in this demo, I will not write each and every code one by one on the Arduino IDE. So I will just copy this line chart example code from here, and I will do some changes according to the applications that we need. So I will paste it here. And let's start doing some modifications to this code. So we'll keep this line chart.h library, TFT ASP library initialization, the maximum size of data, I will keep it as 50, and then the data type, the buffer, and the setup. So inside the setup, I will add the pin initialization. So pin mode, we'll set it as VIO mic. VIO mic will be set as an input. So this we will keep. TFT begin, setting the rotation and then creating the buffer. And the inside the loop, we'll keep this, filling the screen in white. And after this, we'll write int val. So to the variable val, we'll type analog read. So this is to obtain the analog readings from the VIO mic. So from the VIO mic, the analog readings will be stored into val. So after that, here we'll change this to val, because we will store all these analog readings into val. So data.push, then val. After that, let's change this. So this is the line graph title. So let's change it to microphone reading, and then let's change the thickness to 2. So we'll keep this. This is the horizontal alignment, and this is the vertical alignment, and this is the width. So here we will keep these lines, and this bit of code is setting for the line graph. So here we will change this one, the point where y-axis starts. So let's change it to 300, and here let's change the line graph color to red. So this is to push this code to the LCD screen, and there's a delay of 50 milliseconds. So now let's upload this code to the board. That's it for this video. If you guys like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay updated with us. So, see you guys in the next video.